I'm not a huge Pete Davidson fan. I think I would want to hang out with him. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I feel like he's a quirky, funny dude, and I feel like he'd be really fun to hang out with and probably make me laugh a lot at like Nobu or something. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to The Hub. Whether or not you're ready to scroll, we're scrolling on with scroll control. Mm-hmm. And it looks like our buddy Pete Davidson may not have been ready to scroll through at SNL for the season premiere. His recent absence from the premiere has viewers questioning whether or not he'll be back at all.
Yeah, though the comedian's team claims he was off filming the new Suicide Squad. Some wonder, seriously? Like, is he gonna come back? Would it be a big deal if he was gone? I mean, not to discredit anything that Pete's ever done, but I just feel like people now know him as Ariana Grande's ex. Yeah. I mean, at least the majority of people do, but I don't know. Were you ever a fan, Bruno? Do you think he'll always remain in Ariana's shadow, or would you miss him if he didn't come back on SNL?
So, I'm not a huge Pete Davidson fan. I think I would want to hang out with him. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I feel like he's a quirky, funny dude, and I feel like he'd be really fun to hang out with and probably make me laugh a lot at like Nobu or something.
That's very specific.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. I just saw a picture of him at Nobu recently with like Kid Cudi and Timothy Chalamet.
Oh, wow. You're so fancy.
He had this weird dinner date with like him and Kanye. Okay, we're getting
off. Oh, I know exactly what you're talking about. Picture, you weren't there?
No, I wasn't there. Oh. I just you imagine them and like, oh yeah, bring Bruno.
I was like, happen. Look at you and your friends.
Hey, I'm glad you thought I was there. Yeah, so Pete, like, he, you know, he'd be good in like a situation like that. But I'm not a big fan of his comedy. I think I'm into cynical and dark comedy, but he takes it to this level to me that isn't, he kind of like loses the humor. Mm. And then it's really like shot for like shock value.
Got
or like cringe factor, which I think you have to do that. It gets tricky.
Yeah.
I like it depending on the person and the way it's kind of delivered. Mm-hmm. So I'm very particular about comedy. So I think with him, it's more just like his style doesn't really match with mine. Mm-hmm. But I think he does offer a unique perspective on SNL. He talks a lot about mental health and what he struggles with. And it's kind of like he does this like POV comedy almost.
Yeah.
Where he shares his soul.
I mean, I obviously knew who Pete Davidson was, but like I didn't really pay attention until Ariana Grande. Right. But that's just me and like my demographic. I also don't watch SNL anymore.
Oh, right.
I wait if there's like a skit that's, you know, kind of popping off, I'll go on YouTube and I'll watch it. But I guess thinking of the cast, like he's probably one of the more like younger, like for the younger generation, even like younger than us.
Definitely.
So I think for like SNL's just whole audience might be good to have him around, but who knows if he's doing Suicide Squad, who's directing that? James Gunn? Like it's gonna kill it. So he's doing fine without Ariana Grande.
Yes.
Now scrolling on in other news, rapper Lil Nas X announced that he will be taking a break from music after putting forth what we know as the greatest performing single of all time, Old Town Road, which is like mind-blowing. It became the longest running hit in Hot 100 history above Mariah Carey and Boyz II Men. How is this okay? This newfound success brought many quick and drastic changes to the rapper's life. The singer announced that he's taking a break from the music game in order to nurse himself both emotionally and physically. Although we gotta say, I mean, it sounds a little bit familiar to another artist.
Yes, it's definitely ringing some bells. Mm-hmm. I'm tasting notes of Nicki Minaj's recent fake retirement, where the rapper announced to her barbs that she would be retiring to start a family. Then she took it back with a vague tweet asking her fans to tune into her Queen Radio so that she could explain what she actually meant. Then she announced the drop of a new album and like, what?
And we really haven't heard any news, but apparently we're still supposedly waiting on a new album. Okay. But either way, at least she didn't physically hurt anyone because at a recent show, rapper DaBaby left the stage and went down into an audience, which most rappers do.
Yeah, I saw a video
he continued the performance among the crowd, and then an unidentified woman rushed the rapper, to which his security responded by punching her in the face. Seriously?
I shouldn't laugh.
The woman fell limp to the floor. I mean, if you guys see this video, it's shocking and also very sad.
It's really sad.
And she stayed there for minutes from what was shown on security cameras. Then later on, the security guard claimed that he didn't know it was a woman. He thought it was a man. And that she should have just kept her hands to herself altogether and avoided what happened. So what are your thoughts on this?
Okay, so It definitely is not funny, but I'm laughing because it's so outrageous what happened.
Yeah.
So here's the deal. Number one, I actually believe that the security guard might have thought it was a dude. It gets, I've been in those mosh pits at concerts. It gets real crazy.
Yeah.
And especially if you're paid a lot of money to protect the person who's singing, you're going to defend them at all costs. So, mm-hmm. so if that's, you know, if that's what happened and that's what went down, I really believe she should not have kept grabbing, because you see her grabbing him over and over again, and it's like, what did she think was going to happen? You know, that nothing good's going to happen if you're grabbing a famous rapper
yeah.
at a
especially
show.
Especially after, I think he was like even pushing her away.
Right.
I also feel like though, with today's like rap industry, like having those kind of chaotic shows is something that's very like popular amongst rappers today. Obviously Travis Scott, we see that all the time. People like jumping off balconies,
right.
getting carried out on stretchers, like same thing with Uzi Vert, like freaking jumping off things.
Injury is in.
Injury is so in.
So in. Speaking
but it's
of
really
it,
not.
Speaking it's of injured, really not. I feel injured right now.
Oh no.
My back.
Do we have to take a break?
I've been standing too long.
Oh.
Not right now, but before this.
Okay.